the latest in conservation and turkey hunting updates. This is Firebreaks and Flydowns.
I'm Pat Dorsey. I'm the Director of Conservation Operations for the West Region of the National Wild Turkey Federation. So I've got all of the Rocky Mountain states west to the Pacific coast, but I live in the southwest corner of Colorado. And I just wanted to give you a heads up on what I'm seeing for turkey behavior down here in the southwest. We've still got a lot of snowpack in the mountains, and the turkeys have a tendency to follow the snow line up in elevation with the melting snow. So what I'm seeing so far is turkeys still in big winter flocks, groups of toms together. Like the other day, I saw a group of 20 toms hanging out together, but I did hear one gobble the other day. So it's a good sign that they're breaking up, and I'm starting to see a few individuals here and there. I hope everybody has a safe turkey hunting season, and let's see some birds.
Hi, I'm Mitchell Blake, district biologist, for NWTF in Pennsylvania, New York, Maryland, Delaware, and New Jersey. And I wanted to talk to you folks about what we're doing in New York currently, right now this month. We are working with the New York DEC in out of Region 7, the Cortland office, specifically looking at the Connecticut Hill Wildlife Management Area. And for these folks, back in 2022, we funded, NWTF funded, $20,000 worth of wildlife opening restoration and refurbishment. And currently in this fiscal year spending, NWTF in New York has contributed or agreed to contribute close to $12,000 for the purchase of an ATV pull behind no-till seed drill, largely to help plant a lot of these wildlife and openings that we are that we allocated funding for in 2022. So on the Connecticut Hill WMA, they have identified over 201 acres that they would like to refurbish, and we have purchased the seed for a lot of those acres, and now we're helping them with the vehicle to get that seed into the ground. The last few weeks, I actually have spent some time in a turkey blind, actually in Pennsylvania, trying to round out wild turkey trapping, specifically looking at banding gobblers and jakes. And from what I can tell you, turkeys are no longer interested in food, and they are much more interested in females, at least on the male end. A lot of gobbling in the morning, definitely a lot of strutting. And really not too much else going on. So birds are sorting the flock up with groups of hens, definitely two and three gobblers at a time. Jakes are even chasing as well.
I'm Ryan Boyer, district biologist for the National Wild Turkey Federation, responsible for our conservation program delivery in Michigan, Indiana, and Ohio. And right now we're probably, hopefully, at the tail end of our more typical end of March, early April type of weather. We still had a little bit of snow that had come across in a recent storm in the northern part of my district through the UP and the northern lower peninsula of Michigan. Things are warming up. The length of the days are increasing, causing that shift in the hormones, and birds have started breaking up there as of the last couple weeks into smaller groups and becoming a little bit more visible to the public. So we're starting to get some feedback, and folks from the general public, our membership, and are seeing birds out and about. And I think collectively, it's safe to say that folks are fired up and they're excited about turkey season coming in here in about a month. Here, things will start kicking off within my district here in Indiana and Michigan, and then opening up in Ohio. So we've got a lot of great projects and great partnerships that are ongoing, where we've got contractors out facilitating work for us under our conservation program delivery. Some of the ones most notably our work and our partnership with the Wayne National Forest. We've got contractors down there actively working on some mechanical and chemical treatment of understory and midstory removal, timber stand improvement, with a focus on trying to assist with oak and hickory regeneration. In addition to that, we've got other aspects of the project that we have tied in that are focused on improving early successional habitats for nesting and brood rearing habitat for wild turkeys in Ohio. And we've got a number of other projects that we've supported throughout the state through our competitive request for proposals that we put out each year, including one where the state board approved providing $50,000 to the Ohio Division of Wildlife to help them enhance their forest health on some of their managed wildlife areas across the state. So that's a really exciting partnership and a lot of great active project work being done and completed throughout the state of Ohio. Shifting gears and moving over into Indiana, we also run a competitive request for proposals there and have a number of active projects ongoing. Some of the ones completed here more recently include assisting Muscatatuck with the cost to conduct some prescribed firework on some of their larger prairie restoration sites, and help cover the cost for purchasing native seed and the rental for the equipment to get all of that planted on those sites on Muscatatuck National Wildlife Refuge. In addition to that, we're working with some of our other project partners and completing some dormant season mechanical treatments across a few other fish and wildlife areas in Indiana, notably Jasper Pulaski Fish and Wildlife Area. We just helped them complete some mechanical treatment and understory enhancement there on their fish and wildlife areas as well. And then moving up into Michigan, we're wrapping up two of our Michigan DNR wildlife habitat grant projects, which include a number of different partners that are involved to help us reach our objectives to promote wild turkey habitat and enhancements throughout the state. And in addition to those grants and projects being done throughout northern Michigan and southwest Michigan, we also have two active stewardship agreements with the Manistee National Forest, with a primary focus of enhancing, restoring, and protecting oak savanna habitats for wild turkeys. And so we've got some contractors right now still working on completing and wrapping up some manual mechanical chemical treatments, and then we'll be shifting gears into completing some additional protection work here shortly, and then moving into the summer months, we're going to transition into additional treatment types moving thereafter. So a lot of exciting projects, and I think folks are excited for turkey season to be getting here and chomping at the bit, and I'm excited as much as everybody else. I just patiently waiting our turn here for things to come into season.
Yeah, right now in kind of South Georgia, North Florida, the low country of South Carolina, kind of that middle of the coastal plain areas of the region, southeast, that seems like the hens are got the gobblers locked down pretty good right now. They're pretty scattered. So, you know, you'll see a gobbler have, you know, two or three or four hens, and pretty quiet after fly down, it seems like. So it's making for some pretty tough hunting. If you just get up, set up in an area where, you know, some birds are using, you know, maybe have some good luck mid morning possibly. But yeah, they're definitely doing their thing right now. That same area should start seeing some egg laying pretty soon, maybe within the week or so, start seeing some egg laying, and, you know, nest initiation is somewhere around April 6th to 10th. So they'll be sitting on nests in the next couple weeks, probably, in this part of the world. Down south in South Florida, I mean, there's already nests on the ground, active incubations happening, for sure. So they are in the middle, in the throes of it, as they say. As far as, you know, some land management tips and techniques go, when if you're looking to plant here pretty soon, I know folks are looking to do that throughout the southeast. It's just important to make sure that soil temperatures are above about 60 to 65 degrees before you start planting. Sometimes people want to jump the gun when temperatures start rising and things start to grow, but that seed needs to be in some warmer soil. So between that and making sure you have enough moisture in the ground, which so far this right now it's been pretty wet, so moisture shouldn't be an issue this year, but just make sure soil temperatures are above 60 degrees before you start putting seed in the ground. That will be a big help to your food plots.